Welcome to our sweet home. I am Glory Ezema.
I am Augustina Anyanwu. Welcome to our show today.
So our topic today, we're going to address our men and women that have helped us in the house.
Right.
So we're going to give you a little advice on how to treat your household helpers. We have to remember that things that we do in the house is a lot, especially taking care of the children, taking them to school, bringing them back, and those things is not something that one person can do. So sometimes you need help. So some people might go to the village to get their relatives to come and help them. Others might go to, you know, some of the families that do not have enough money to train their children and ask them to give you some of their children so that they can be household helpers for you. But what we have realized recently is that a lot of people do not take care of them very well. So let's give you a little advice on what you can do, because it's always good to treat every child as if it's your own, whether you are the biological mother or not. So my friend, what are some of the stories that we have heard about people and their household
helpers? We have had a lot, but based on what myself I have seen, and then if I join into the ones I had, I think we can draw a little conclusion, and then that would be, that's what we base on our advice on. The rule of thumb is treat others as you would like to be treated. Because all of us were once a child, and you know that. And one thing is that most parents that let their child go to stay with somebody else actually love them no matter the economic situation.
Exactly.
But they send their child to somebody they look up to.
Like families say, that have money.
Yeah, and say, I know you will train my child. I know you will do this to my child. But unfortunately, some of the women in particular, because men, some of them are not even around. Some of the women, like, they treat them as if, let me use the word, enslave them.
Thank you.
To the extent, even to eat. They have to eat until every chore in the house is done. Go to sleep when everybody is sleeping at weird hours. And some of them, unfortunately, don't even send those children to school. They lay them to hawk. And then they are dressing. If they go to church, nobody will tell you that this person following this rich woman,
it's not her child,
is a med. Let me use that word.
Well, the word med that you use is even good, because actually, when you look at it, we had about slavery. The story of slavery that is still haunting our people up to today, because we felt so bad, especially when we came over here and found out what our brothers and sisters went through when they came from Africa. So it's heartbreaking when we hear about Africans enslaving other Africans too.
Little children. Exactly. Not even that's a, what do they call it here?
It's when you're child labor. Exactly.
Yeah.
So you go to the villages and you bring these children to the city. And you feed your children. Your children eat on the dining table. But your housemate eats on the floor. Just like a dog. Imagine if your child is being treated like that. How would you feel? They wake up in the morning and you send them to the markets. Sometimes they go with no food. And they're hawking the street trying to get money for you, maybe selling like petty things. And they come back in the middle of the night.
Wow.
Sometimes when they come back, they will start sweeping or start washing the dishes and your own children are sleeping in bed. These are people's children. Let's think of it. Because some of them actually, because I know some stories, these are children from, you know, good family or maybe wealthy families, but because of life circumstances, either they lost their father or they lost their mother, now they don't have anybody to train them in school. So they go to the cities and live with these rich men and women in Africa. And then they treat them like slaves.
Yeah.
It's very unfortunate. And then what about the drivers, even the drivers that drive the cars?
That one I call it being ignorant, because when you want to take your life or your children's life and put in a vehicle and ask the driver to take them to school, and you're not treating the driver right, or yourself, or the driver of your husband, then you just or the gate man, even the gate man.
Exactly.
The maid handles most of your food all the time. Mm-hmm. You don't know what goes on in that man's mind.
That's
even
true.
The bitterness alone will make that food to be poison to you.
That's
talk
true.
About the driver and the gate man. You don't want to treat them well. You belittle them. You look down on them. It's life circumstances because we don't know tomorrow.
Exactly.
We do not know
tomorrow is going to be.
Okay. So that's what I'm saying to people that maltreat people, because right now you have upper hand, or you're the one that paid their salary, or you're the one that hired them to you. They don't have nothing. They're nothing without you. You need to slow down. You need to think about it.
Because
what if? Yes, anything can happen.
It could be your own child.
Or anything can happen to anybody.
That's true.
And then who will raise your own child?
Mm-hmm.
Because like you said earlier, some of them become mad, not because that's not what they want to do.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe because of life circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know tomorrow. So I think it's a good advice to treat those people, those children, treat them as if they are your own.
Exactly.
Because when they grow up, they are not going to forget you, good or bad.
That's true.
Right?
That is true. That is true. Because actually, other parts of the world, people treat their household helpers even better than anything else. Because these are people that are closest to you.
Mm-hmm.
They are the ones that are cooking your food.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, they are the ones that are driving your children.
Mm-hmm.
So why would you maltreat someone that is actually providing care, like the closest care to you? That's how I look at it. So my brothers and sisters.
Oh. You know one thing you said?
Mm-hmm.
I think we call them household helpers, right?
Yes.
Unfortunately, they become like the caretaker of everything. Because when they have to clean, when they have to cook, take your children to school and bring them back, run all the errands, and if they have to go and fetch water, they have to go and do that. Actually, what is the madam of the house doing? Those little children are there to run a little errand for you, do little stuff. You leave their responsibility, even doing your children's homework. You leave it for the little child that is not even up to 10 to do for you. And then she takes the position of an adult.
Exactly.
They are helpers. And at the same time, you're supposed to teach them because you are not the mother, they say.
Mm-hmm.
And the children learn
by
what they see.
Mm-hmm.
They learn by example. You got to model for them. So that at the end, they will say, oh, auntie used to do that. So you cannot leave them and leave the minor to take care of a minor.
Exactly.
It doesn't work like that, madam. Mm-hmm.
And the parents that gave you those children,
they trust you.
They trust you.
With their children.
And they did it so that you can be the mother to that child.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you're a father, a child that is fatherless that you took into your home, I mean, they're looking up to you to be their father. So why would you treat them differently and treat your children differently? Why would you allow them to eat on the floor or eat like leftover food?
Do you know they beat them too?
That one is an abuse. Actually.
They beat them.
They beat them. And they will not even for minor stuff.
For nothing.
I know.
Every time they tell them, you lie.
Exactly. What about their clothes?
That's what I was saying. Yes, and when they go to
big
church.
Men, the big men.
When they go to church or any place, you will know a maid. You will know a household girl right away.
Just by looking
if
at
you
them.
Can't go to their house, the way they will yell at them and pull their ear and order them to go bring something for you to
and
eat.
And they will not do that
and
to
you
their children.
That is visiting, you're not going to question that.
Exactly.
They call them names,
yes.
Humiliate them, talk
yes.
about their parents.
Yes.
There's so many
that's
things.
Slavery.
They talk about their parents.
Exactly.
Your wretched parent, if I didn't take you, come on, give me a break.
Exactly.
A woman.
So, I'm our sisters, please, in Africa.
Please, madam.
This is a forum that we're pleading with all of you. These are people's children. And it could be you. It could be your own child that will be in a situation like that. Because nobody knows tomorrow. Please treat those children well. Because they will, like my friend said, they will never forget you if you're very kind to them. And then if you maltreat them, they will also never forget what you have put them through. Because, you see, we have all gone out to the Western world.
Mm.
They have babysitters. And they treat their babysitters so well.
Mm-hmm.
So treat every human being with dignity, whether they have it or not. Because you never know what it will be tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Just because you have it today does not mean
you will have it
tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
At the end, yes. We say the young shall grow. So please, madam, if you go and take any child to help you, let that child be a helper. Make sure you show that child the right way to go. Send them to school.
Thank you.
When the people are going to school, not in the evening.
That's true.
Please, don't leave the whole housework for them because they are young children too.
Exactly.
Children cannot take care of children.
Mm-hmm.
They are above the house. You need to see what is going on too. Please, you need to take care of the fatherless. Take care of the poor. And your reward will come from heaven.
That's true. And buy the same clothes. If you're buying clothes for your children, buy the same clothes for your housekeeper. And then even shoes. Some of them walk around with no shoes.
Nothing.
But your children have like so many pairs of shoes laying down there. We are all mothers. The mom of those children went through the same thing that you went through.
Same pain, 9 months.
So please treat those children as you would like your own children to
be treated. That's the rule of the game.
Exactly.
Treated us as you would like to be treated.
That's true.
Yes.
God will reward you.
Yes.
So that's our episode today, actually. It's a very touchy episode because we hear these stories of young children that are being maltreated because they are household helpers. So please, let's do the right thing. Because most of us, we're very religious. Depending on our religious denominations, we go to church, we pray. But if you're praying, it's always good to practice what you preach. So
yeah.
Those household helpers that you have in there, they're human beings just like any other human being. So treat them right. It doesn't matter the status. That's our episode today. So thank you, madam. Thank you, sir. That's what we call them in Africa. The big men and the big women of the country.
Right.
But please remember the poor.
Take care of them.
The theme is treat your household helpers as you would
like somebody else to treat your own child.
That's true.
All right.
Thank you.
God bless you and keep up the good work.
Exactly. All so right. Watch us next week as we continue.